morphisms. Suppose R is an arbitrary ring and S is an ideal in R, then capital S is a subgroup of additive abelian group of R. We can form cosets of S in R. Since R is an additive abelian group and if A belongs to R, then the right coset S plus A will be equal to corresponding left coset A plus S. So we call S plus A simply a coset of S in R. From group theory, we know that if A comma B belong to R, then S plus A equal to S plus B implies and implied by A minus B belongs to S. The cosets of S in R are called the residue classes of capital S in R. We denote the residue classes of capital S in capital R by R divided by S. Thus, R divided by S is equal to the set of all cosets of the form S plus A, where A belongs to R. We can prove that R by S is a ring with respect to addition and multiplication of residue classes, and this ring is called quotient ring or ring of residue classes. Note, if capital S is an ideal of a ring R, then the set R by S is equals to the set of all cosets S plus A such that A belongs to R of all residue classes of S in R forms a ring with respect to two composition in R by S defined by as follows. The first operation is addition, that is S plus A plus S plus B, that is addition or the sum of two cosets S plus A plus S plus B equals to S plus A plus B. That is, we write S only once on the right hand side, and the multiplication is defined as S plus A into S plus B is equals to S plus A into B. Number 2, if R by S is a ring of residue classes of S in R, then the first one is, if capital R is commutative, so is capital R by S. The second point is, if R has unit element 1, so also has R by S, namely S plus 1. Homomorphism of rings. First, we define what is homomorphism into. A mapping F from a ring R into a ring R dash is said to be a homomorphism of R into R dash if the first condition is F of A plus B is equals to F of A plus F of B for all A comma B belong to the ring R, and F of A into B is equals to F of A into F of B for all A comma B belong to R. If you recall, into homomorphism of groups, we have only one condition, because in a group we have only one binary operation, whereas in a ring we have two binary operations, namely addition and multiplication. Therefore, we must have two conditions, namely condition number 1 and condition number 2. Note, if F is a homomorphism of a ring R into a ring R dash, then the second one is F of minus A is equals to minus of F of A It is true for all A belong to R. If F is from R on to R dash, where R and R dash are two rings, is an on to homomorphism, then R dash is called homomorphic image of the ring R. If A comma B belong to R, since the function f is from R to R dash is a homomorphism, therefore the images of A and B under the function f, namely f of A and f of B, must be in R dash. That is, if A and B are from the domain ring, then f of A, f of B must be in the codomain ring. We will now define what is kernel of a homomorphism. If F is a homomorphism of a ring R into a ring R dash, the kernel of F is the set of all elements of R which are mapped into the zero element, namely zero dash of the ring R dash. That is, kernel of F is equal to set of all X belong to R such that F of X is equals to 0 dash. We consider this is the ring R and this is the ring R dash, and the mapping F is from R to R dash, and suppose R has elements A, B, C, E, X, Y, so on, and R dash have elements A dash, B dash, 0 dash, C dash, X dash, so on. Here 0 dash is the 0 element of R dash, E is the 0 element of R. Then we assume that A is mapped into 0 dash, C is mapped into 0 dash, and the identity element E also mapped into 0 element of R dash. Then what is kernel of F? Kernel of F is set of all elements of R which are mapped into the element of 0 dash, the 0 element of R dash. Here we have only three elements, namely A, C, E, which are mapped into the zero element, zero dashed of R dash. Therefore, kernel of F here is the set containing elements A, C, E, where here we take E as the identity element in R. That is, kernel of F is equals to the set A, C and E. That is, F of A is 0 dash, F of C equal to 0 dash, F of E equal to 0, F of 0 equal to 0 dash. If an element A belongs to kernel F, then we must have F of A equal to 0 dash. Whenever we have the relation F of A equal to 0 dash, then A must be in the kernel F. Therefore, A belongs to kernel F implies and implied by F of A is equals to 0 dash. So, whenever an element A belongs to kernel of F, immediately we can write F of A equal to 0 dash. Similarly, whenever we have F of A equal to 0 dash, then the A must be in kernel F. We shall now prove a theorem. If F is a homomorphism of a ring R into a ring R dash with kernel S, then S is an ideal of R. Proof: let F from R to R dash be a homomorphism. That is, F must satisfy two conditions, namely F of A plus B equal to F of A plus F of B for all a comma b belong to R, here the operation is addition, and f of a into b equal to f of a into f of b for all a comma b belong to R, here the operation is multiplication. Let 0 and 0 dash be 0 elements of R and R dash respectively. Let capital S be the kernel of F. Definition of kernel of the function, S is equals to set of all elements X of R such that F of X is equals to 0 dash. Now we have to show that S is an ideal of R. We know that F of 0 equal to 0 dash, this implies 0 belongs to S, because this means S has at least one element, namely the 0 element of the ring R, and hence S is non-empty and S is a subset of R. We know that if you want to prove that a non-empty subset I of a ring R is an ideal of R, then it is sufficient to prove that the first one is A belongs to I, B belongs to I implies A minus B belongs to I. That is, this is a condition for I is a subgroup and R into S belongs to I, and S into R belongs to I. For all R belong to R and for all S belong to I. Therefore, first we have to show that S is a subgroup of R. How to prove S is a subgroup of R? To prove S is a subgroup of R, by this statement, A comma B belong to S implies A minus B belong to S. How do you show that A minus B belongs to S? We know that F of X is equal to 0 dash implies and implied by X belong to S. So if we say X belongs to S, then F of X must be equal to 0. To show that A minus B belongs to S, we have to show that F of A minus B equal to 0 dash. That is, in the place of X, we are taking A minus B. That is, to show that A minus B belongs to S, we have to show that F of A minus B equals to 0 dash. Therefore, we have to consider F of A minus B. Let A comma B belong to S. Then by definition of kernel of F, X belongs to R implies F of X is equal to 0 dash. Here A belongs to S implies F of A equal to 0 dash. B belongs to S implies F of B equals to 0 dash. Now consider F of A minus B. We have to show that F of A minus B equals to 0 dash. F of A minus B can be written as F of A plus of minus B. That can be written as F of A plus F of minus B, because F is a homomorphism. F of A plus B equal to F of A plus F of B. Therefore, F of A plus minus B is equal to F of A plus F of minus B. Also, we know that F of minus B equal to minus of F of B. Therefore, we have F of A minus F of B. But what is F of A? 0 dash. What is F of B? 0 dash. Therefore, this is equal to 0 dash minus 0 dash. What is 0 dash minus 0 dash? Equal to 0 dash. Thus, we have shown that F of A minus B equal to 0 dash. This means A minus B belongs to S. Therefore, A comma B belong to S implies A minus B belong to S. Then by the known theorem, S is a subgroup of R. Thus, the first condition is over. Now we have to show the second condition. The second condition is I is a left ideal as well as right ideal. So now we have to prove that A belongs to S or belongs to S implies AR, RA belong to S. That is, this S is a right ideal as well as left ideal of R. We know that f of x is equal to 0 dash if and only if x belong to S. Therefore, to show that AR, RA belong to S, we have to show that f of AR equal to 0 dash and f of RA equal to 0 dash. If f of AR equal to 0 dash and f of RA equal to 0 dash, then we conclude that AR and RA both belong to S. Therefore, we have to consider f of AR. Let R belongs to capital R and A belong to S. Since A belongs to S, S is a kernel of F, f of A equal to 0 dash. Now consider f of AR. Now we have to show that f of AR equal to 0 dash. But what is F? F is a homomorphism. Therefore, f of A into R is equal to f of A into f of R. But what is f of A? F of A is 0 dash. This equals to 0 dash. Thus, f of AR equal to 0 dash. That is, f of AR equal to 0 dash implies AR belongs to S for all R belong to R and A belong to S. Again, consider f of RA. What is f of RA? Since f is a homomorphism, f of R into A is f of R into f of A. But what is the value of f of A? F of A value is 0 dash. Therefore, f of R into 0 dash, f of R into 0 dash is 0 dash. Therefore, f of RA equal to 0 dash implies RA belongs to S for all R belong to R and A belong to S. Thus, we have shown that the first one is A comma B belong to S implies A minus B belongs to S. Therefore, S is a subgroup of R. And the second condition, AR comma RA belong to S for all R belong to R and A belong to S. Hence, by this result, we say that capital S is equals to kernel of F is an ideal of R. The theorem, every homomorphic image of a commutative ring is commutative. Proof, let F be a homomorphism of a commutative ring R onto a ring R dash, where R dash is a homomorphic image of R. Now we have to show that R dash is also commutative. Let A dash comma B dash belong to R dash. Since F is onto homomorphism, there exist elements A comma B belong to R, so that f of A equals to A dash and f of B equals to B dash. Since R is commutative, A comma B belong to R implies AB equals to BA. Let us call it as equation number 1. Now we have to show that A dash into B dash is equals to B dash into A dash. Now consider A dash B dash. What is A dash? A dash is F of A. What is B dash? F of B. Therefore, A dash B dash is equals to F of A into F of B. What is F? F is a homomorphism. Therefore, F of A into F of B is F of A into B. But what is A into B? By 1, A into B equal to B into A. Therefore, this is equal to F of B into A using 1. What is F?
f is a homomorphism. Therefore, f of b into a is equal to f of b into f of a. What is f of b? B dash. What is f of a? A dash. That is equal to b dash into a dash. Thus, we have shown that a dash b dash is equal to b dash into a dash. This shows that r dash is commutative.